cold to read. No time. I get mine and make no excuses. Waste of precious breath. No time. The sun shines on everyone. Everyone, love yourself to death. So you gotta fire up.
It is about fucking time. The hype was real for I don't know how long, no. And I am sorry that I did not get to post the opening video yesterday. I was so deep into my team that I was just like, fuck it, I need to get ahead and play this shit and just dive into this shit. Because I just couldn't wait. I couldn't take the time to literally stop and make a video. I couldn't do it. So I'm just showing you guys my starter packs to begin with and the first pack opening, which turned out to be 100k VC. Because most of the time I'm spending on 2k right now, I just getting through domination. Because domination last year, I don't know if you guys remember, my full domination pack opening video, opening every pack from domination, including the all stars and Sapphire Nate Ultra Brawl and all of that. It turned out to be my biggest video of all time. It is the biggest video on my channel. So I'm repeating that and trying to open all the domination packs again and do it as quick as possible. I'm about halfway through domination right now, looking to get the video up by Monday and finish up. So to begin with, I'm just showing you guys what my team started out with and how I went into domination with the first set of players, and I'm here to tell you that I am not disappointed so far with the gameplay with my team overall. I'm definitely impressed and I'm actually enjoying the mode. Fucking crazy to say, no, yes, fucking crazy. Now to begin with, obviously we're going to get all the shit players from the beginning packs, but obviously they give you those pre-order packs and the special moment Jordan, and the pre-order packs were actually very, very kind. I honestly could have played a road to playoffs game with the team I had after opening my pre-order packs. That is something crazy to be able to say, because that special moment Jordan, it is still a fucking Michael Jordan. He can't have a 75 mid-range, which he does have, but he is still going to make mid-ranges like his name is Michael Jordan from 95-96. That is just how it work. That is the Jordan rules of 2K. Now these are all the packs that I got to begin with, and I was not disappointed at all, like I did say, and you're going to see that I actually get a really good dynamic player out of one of them, a dynamic player that did sell for quite a bit, and I think most people do get an automatic dynamic player in these packs. Everybody I've heard from has gotten one, and I think the friend that you just saw me get a party invite from, he got a fucking dynamic Dwight Howard in his opening packs. What the fuck is that? That is one of the best things. That Dwight Howard is automatically the go-to cheese center for everybody to start my team. That is what, he's the equalizer center of all time. Now as far as the gameplay goes, I think that this gameplay is it's the best that I've played in a lot. This is the best that I've played since 2K13. I can honestly say that, because everything is just more realistic now. If you play good defense, and which is not hard at all to play good defense, just practice your fucking on ball, you're going to get good at it. There's no excuse this year whatsoever. If you're a cheeser, you're just a cheeser. You have no excuse, you just want cheese. So if you practice good defense, you're going to win your games. There is no such thing as patch 4 anymore. A hand up in the face actually means something. Your centers aren't bitches anymore, and then we'll actually dunk and finish at the rim and not do some bitch layup and not get a full and one. And now here comes Chandler Parsons, who ends up being my dynamic rated player, which was a pretty good pull for me. Chandler Parsons is actually really, if I didn't need the MT, I would have kept him. But as of right now, I did sell him, because the dynamic Chandler Parsons is worth up to about 10,000 MT, and that was a nice look, a pretty penny that could have gotten me somebody much better, a gold player, which it did end up getting me. Also, this is why my Hidden Gem series might be an even bigger hit this year, because Chandler Parsons is a player, he's one of those players that are poised to have a good year. He's a 79 rating right now, and is his dynamic card, and the Mavs really, he's basically the second option after Dirk in reality. So he is poised to have such a good year, at least 16 to 18 points a game, that there's no way he's not going to break past a 79, become an 80 to like an 83, I would see becoming realistically, turn into a gold card, and boom, he has gone up 4 to 5 overall points just like that. Hidden gems are fucking crazy this year. Also on that note, because I might as well go over everything I'm going to do in 16 at this point, hidden gems are probably going to be much bigger, like I did mention, because there are so many themes to the hidden gem that now it's even more interesting. I can have a whole nother series of just dynamic players. This is just for people that don't keep up with the NBA as much. I follow almost every team pretty well, because I watch game time every single night and I watch how every single player is doing, so I'm able to tell the people who don't do that, hey, this motherfucker is going off, go and buy him dynamic card as soon as you can. Anyway, now we have gotten to the 30,000 VC that they gave you to begin with the pre-order bonus. bonus, and I opened about 4 packs, which is pretty fair. 7,500 for the most expensive pack is fair. I think that is cheaper than last year. I'm pretty sure that is cheaper than last year. At least it feels that way anyway. 4 packs just for the pre-order, and I got some fairly good players. Damari Carroll, you might not think of it like that, but Damari Carroll is actually really fucking good. He was a borderline gold player, 79 overall. Great person to have, great person to start my team with when I was going to domination, because one, he has an 86 three-pointer. Two, he has an 86 on-ball defense. He is just my mini little silver Paul George. And then I go ahead and get Jabari Parker, which isn't bad either, because he's still a rookie hype beast. I sold him for at least like 4,000 to 5,000 as well. ACL is not included. And then the next guy that I get to the next pack could be a hidden gem to start the year. He's a 79 overall silver, Eric Gordon from the Pelicans. Fucking Eric Gordon, his form, I know if some of you know it, the form is very, very annoying to get down. Is a little bit quicker this year, is not as hard to get down, especially the moving mid-range. But Eric Gordon has a fucking 91 three-pointer. I don't know which fucking guy on the Pelicans them watching that gets injured every 2 games, but this is not the fucking Eric Gordon that I know of. And then I get bum-ass Drew Glenn to end it. But this is not the fucking Eric Gordon I know of. And with a 91 three-pointer, look at that. Already in one pack opening, with the pre-order packs that them give you and the 30,000 VC that them give you and me just opening about 3 packs with VC that I bought on my own, I was already able to get to the 10k MT milestone. And that is already MT in my pocket that I did use to pick up another gold player. So I'm actually satisfied. This is what I mean by satisfied with my team with the mode as a whole so far, because I've yet to spend much money at all. With those packs that I've owned, Patrick Beverley, another really good silver player to start, lockdown defender, 90 on-ball defense, and you know how big defense is in this game now. But the point is, I've barely spent any money, and I have an actually really good team already, and I haven't even had the best luck, to be honest. I've seen people with way better luck than this so far. So I'm actually satisfied with what the mode is doing at this point, and after looking at the road to the playoffs to begin with, you get packs from beating that too, and Willie Cauley-Stein, I'm going to tell you right now that you need to go out and fucking buy him if you want a silver center that can get the job done. He's athletic, he's going to catch lobs, and he has a 90 block. I think he is one of the best shot blockers that I've used in this game so far, and I've used Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, so that is fucking saying something right now. He is a mini Hassan Whiteside, if you're wondering how he's going to play for you. And as I've been playing through domination, and even in team up, I can honestly say that silver players, them not useless anymore. Them can definitely get the job done if you use them in the right way. There is no need to have an overpowered tier. And then I see the goal overlay, and I get fucking Tony Park. I didn't mind that pull at all. He is a great point guard for me, because he can finish and shoot mid-range in the pick and roll. He was amazing. Amazing for me to start domination. At 83 overall is like kind of low to me, but Tony Parker, I already have a good point guard to start, and I was happy I had the Jordan. He's my go-to scorer. Look, the team was coming together within one pack opening. There's nothing I can really say about it so far. I had a good enough team to head right into domination, start dominating and getting 3 really good cards, and then I get another gold card overlay. I'm hype, I'm like, Kobe, please, Lillard, and I get LaMarcus fucking Aldridge. I was so hyped. I was like, let's go, bitch. Domination is done. LaMarcus Aldridge with the improved post game, with the 90 mid-range, with his overrated rebounding, with all that shit listed above, I had a really good team already. Tony Parker the point guard, Jordan the wing scoring option, and LaMarcus Aldridge the fucking post scoring option that is going to just kill people down low. I couldn't be more satisfied. Tony Parker's stats are pretty decent, probably exactly what you'd think of them. He has a little 3-pointer to like an 80. The Jordan is basically the rookie Jordan, but with less of a jump shot. That is about it. And can dunk and do everything, but he's still Jordan. LaMarcus Aldridge, I think I'm about 88 feet away at like an 89 hook. But look, the stats are there, you can't see them. And his mid-range is on fucking point. He even has the 3-pointer that the Ruby Aldridge had. He has an 81. I think the Ruby Aldridge had like an 86. But fuck it. Him can still knock down threes. The only thing him can do is that he's just a mediocre defender. And that is fine, because I have good defensive silver big men. I know I have even better ones. But this is the team that I have to end this one pack opening so far. This is me showing you the ungodly fucking 3-pointer of Eric Gordon. And I have nothing really bad to say about the team. I really don't. One pack opening, and I had a good enough team to fly through domination. Like I said, I'm about halfway through it right now, because I can't wait to touch that Amethyst kid and see how he is. I didn't know of Jason Kidd to be that good on the Suns to be Amethyst, but I mean, they had to give you a good reward that kept it interesting. Now, as far as the gameplay is concerned, I'm actually satisfied as well. You'll still find these little annoying things that go and bother you, and you still get trapped in some animations. But more than anything, they fixed what I wanted to see fixed. Defense is fixed. Rebounding is fairly fixed. If you're boxing somebody out, you're going to get the board and not going bounce into them hands through your body and all that shit. Good shots go in. That is fucking huge to me. No, you don't have to have a 90 overall player, pink diamond, whatever the fuck, to be able to say, okay, I can shoot this guy and not feel insecure about the fact that he might have not a high mid range. Like Onyx Wade last year, he'd have like a 76, so many people didn't really want to use him for that exact reason. No, it is good enough. If it's a good shot, it going go in, and I actually really, really love that. You can still zigzag to an extent, but it is stoppable, very, very stoppable, unless they have some kind of 99 overall card that just going to make everything contested. The person you're playing is probably going to get a shot off here and there if them zigzag, but you can stop it now, especially if you play off-ball, because off-ball is OP as fuck. That is one thing you should keep in mind, that off-ball this year is fucking, oh my god, the people that going to play off-ball, but them have really good perimeter defenders, they're going to be annoying to beat, because it's not like against them cheesing because them playing off ball. You can just kind of challenge their manhood and say, fucking play on ball, you bitch. But that don't mean them necessarily going to stop playing on ball. We've established that people just want them W, and that's just going to piss you off even more. But off ball is OP. But for the most part, a lot of things are fixed, and I'm actually loving the game right now, and I probably will until I start playing online in Road to Playoffs, which I plan to complete much quicker this year. The moment I finish Domination, jumping into Road to the Playoffs. So, how are you guys liking the game?